The Living Lab is home to our state-of-the-art facilities used by a range of our Health Sciences and Wellbeing courses. Our scientist complex is made up of four buildings: Darwin, Pasteur, Fleming and Dale. The Living Lab is situated within Fleming Building, which we're going to have a look at now. Our OSCE suite, which stands for Objective Structured Clinical Examination, can be used as a classroom and for practical examinations. Our nursing, paramedic, pharmacy, physiotherapy and occupational therapy and medicine students all use these facilities. Inside you can see a main classroom space with six adjoining pods. These pods may contain different tasks for our students to carry out, each one intended to test a different skill. Students could be asked to read a patient chart, case study, and then go in and talk to an academic, or they could be asked to give a diagnosis to one of our PCPIs. This stands for Patient, Carer and Public Involvement Participants. PCPIs are essentially members of the public, carers, or someone that has an ongoing health condition who works with our students, giving first-hand experience of how you should communicate with patients. They will let you know from experience what is good patient care and bad patient care. The immersive suite is connected to the debrief room and is one of the university's most high-tech learning tools. The debrief room, as you can see, has TV screens around the room and they are linked to the cameras in the immersive suite. The room is three-walled, interactive, and can recreate any possible environment within reason. We can project images, videos, play sounds, and embed information into the walls that can be activated by touch. We can make the immersive suite into varying environments, and this is vital as not all students will be working in a ward. For paramedic students, they could be called to a football field where we can roll out AstroTurf, someone's home where we can wheel in furniture and create a lived-in space, a nightclub where we can turn the music up really loud and darken the lights, and so much more. The immersive suite is incredible and bridges the gap between real life and the classroom. There is also our task trainer room where students can practice smaller tasks before moving into the immersive suite on one of the wards. Opposite the task trainer room is our dispensary. Our dispensary is used for our pharmacy students. There are two dispensaries side by side and students will have classes and workshops in here. We have incredible high-tech mannequins for our students to use. From our Sim mannequins, which include Sim Man, Sim Mom and a child version, the Sim Man 3G is computerised and can be made to simulate any type of injury. He is controlled by an iPad and has a computer in his leg which sends signals to chips around his body. They can blink, breathe, go to the bathroom, bleed and do nearly every bodily function that we can do. The good thing about the mannequins is students can practice on them and learn from their mistakes. We have the Apollo mannequins. These are similar to the Sim Men but a little bit more high tech and a little bit bigger as well. They do every function that the Sim Man does, however they also sweat and cry, and he also has pulse points around his body in the same places that humans would. And finally we have our trauma mannequins. These are based on real life people. Someone will have had their full body scanned and they will be turned into one of these mannequins. We have a range of men, women and children, each varying in height and weight, and they all have different functions. Some you can intubate, you can do chest compressions, you can inject them. Some you can remove a limb and add trauma limbs onto them if you're recreating an accident. You can add real looking diseases, rashes, burns and warts, making them look even more lifelike. Here at the University of Sunderland we have two mock wards in the Living Lab and two over at Helen McArdle. We also have a specialised mental health ward on the top floor of Helen McArdle House. The wards mimic NHS wards, even down to the beds for our nursing students, so when they go on placements they feel comfortable and know the environment because of the wards on campus. Each ward is equipped with a nursing station, treatment room, a sluice room and a demo toilet. The beds have TV screens above them and the patient's stats will be uploaded onto there. We also have two wards over at Helen McArdle House, however they are set up a little differently. Outside we have two ambulance bays and one is usually taken up by our student ambulance. As you can see it looks a little different, that's because it has to. If you are out doing a test or a different scenario in a normal looking ambulance you would be required to stop, so it has to look a little different. Inside, it has all the equipment a normal ambulance would. Helen McArdle House is set up as a patient transfer suite and looks like an ER. Once you go through the doors, the reception desk is on the right hand side and the ward splitting off on the left. One of the wards can also be transformed into a child's ward with smaller beds and equipment. At the top floor of Helen McArdle House, we have a mental health ward. There is a nursing desk at the very front and then six bedrooms adjoining. The bedrooms are based on rooms within a real mental health hospital. There's nothing sharp, everything is touchpad and there are hoists if needed. There is also emergency buttons if patient needed support and safety doors. The Living Lab and Helen McArdle House have incredible industry standard facilities and help prepare our students for placements and their careers post-graduation. Thanks for watching. We hope to see you in the near future.